what can I say? What I just finished watching just now, like literally maybe a few seconds before I even turned on this camera. Fantastic. I took down some notes, but I don't even think I'm really going to go through the notes like that. I'm just going off of my first impressions. I don't think my notes can do it justice. This easily is one of the best matches I've seen personally this year. It's up there for sure. I enjoyed this thoroughly. I literally forgot that today was Wednesday, honestly, and I forgot winter was coming, was happening today. So once I realized what it was, I was recording with the homies for the podcast at the studio. Once we finished that up, I rushed home to get here to watch this match. Fantastic. I enjoyed it. What made me enjoy this match so much is to see how they've been booking Bryan Danielson in AEW. The fact that this guy has been legitimately injuring people, not in a sense of purposely, but in a storyline sense, he's beating people so bad that he's injuring them. He's not coming off as the underdog here. In WWE, they went with the underdog story because that's the story they wanted to tell here. Because they considered him the B-plus player underdog. Here, no, he's not considered the underdog. He's considered an A-plus player as soon as he walked in, and he's been booked that way. He's destroying people in the ring. And what I really love is he's riding that wave of, is he a heel? Is he not a heel? Is he a face? Is he not a face? He's riding the tweener wave. We don't see too many people that are really considered tweeners in WWE, in wrestling in general. He's riding that wave throughout this match. He knew he was going to be booed. They booed the hell out of him. There was people cheering for him, but he knew he was going to be booed. Beginning of the match, he's pissing off, trying to get into Adam Hangman's Adam Page's head by constantly dipping his head outside the ropes. So he has to, back away from him. Like, constantly doing jumping jacks. Like, this is slight work for me. Constantly being pretty much an ass. Not taking him seriously at all. Like, this is all just a joke. Flipping him off. He's flipping off the fans and he's flipping him off. Heel like stuff, but he wasn't cheating. You would think he would try to cheat to win as most traditional heels. No. He wasn't cheating. That's why I said he was riding the wave of heel and face, because he had heel like mannerisms throughout the match, but he wasn't cheating. He was just going to beat your ass and that's it. Play within the rules. And that's it. It came off as, I know I'm better than this guy. I'm going to show y'all why I'm better than this guy. And that's what it was. And I like the fact that this match stayed true to how they've been building him. He was not the underdog. You know who really came off as the underdog here? Adam. Adam Hangman Page came off as the underdog. Of course, he was the crowd favorite going into this match. But he came off as the underdog because he really couldn't get consistent offense against Daniel Bryan. And that's the story they were telling. Daniel's very methodical. Very smart. So he's going to get you off. He knows what moves to avoid. So he'll target those body parts. He was targeting the arm. When Adam got busted open, he started targeting the head. He knew that he didn't want to get hit with the buckshot lariat. His whole mindset was to make sure he avoided certain moves from being hit on him. Smart. I've never got to really experience the American Dragon. I've only seen Daniel Bryan from WWE. But to see Bryan Danielson, the American Dragon, I see what the hype was about before he came to WWE. I see what the hype was about when he was in Indies. This is fantastic. And I see why they went with the 60. It went 60 minutes, which is fantastic on its own. But I see why they went with the route of ending in a draw. Even the way the match ended, Bryan Danielson rolls away after Adam finally hits the buckshot Larry. He rolls away as Adam's trying to pin, but the time ran out. I love that. I'm okay with that. This was a pay-per-view main event. They started off the show with this. So y'all got a 60-minute pay-per-view main event match. Granted, I did hate the picture-in-picture stuff. That shit was kind of annoying, but I get it. Gotta pay the bills. Still, they started off the show hot. To keep people's attention for 60 minutes means you're doing something right. And I don't know what to say other than y'all go watch this match if you haven't. If you are a fan of wrestling, if you've only just been watching WWE primarily, give this match a try. Just give it a try. This was great. I refuse to be one of those guys, oh, I only watch WWE and that's it. If I see something that I like in AEW, I'm gonna at least acknowledge it. And I have to acknowledge it. I wish I could have did a live reaction. I wish I could have live streamed this, but I was busy, you know, doing stuff for the main page. But I will tell you this. This match easily would go down as one of the best matches of this year. One of the best matches I've seen in quite some time. And I am looking forward to their rematch. I'm looking forward to the promos they will have. I'm looking forward to what Bryan Danielson will have to say. Because he literally, in my opinion, he was in control of this match, majority of the match. He did not come off as the underdog. He came off as the guy that's like, yo, I can hold my own here. I'm going to handle up on him. He's not going to beat me like y'all think he will. They have booked Bryan Danielson like a killer. He's giving me Brock vibes. They always book Brock like a killer. Here, they've booked Bryan Danielson like a legit killer. Like he will legit hurt you in that square circle and won't care. And I love it. This is the best version of him I have seen in quite some time. And I love it. He would not have been able to do this type of character role in WWE. I'm just being honest. They were not going to let him come off as aggressive, as this dominant force, as this dominant wrestling machine that he is. They were going to keep him as little cute, adorable, yes, movement Daniel Bryan. No. Here, now I'm here to knock your head off and take the championship. And they made the AEW championship seem so goddamn important, which I really wish WWE would do more of that. Make their main titles feel important. This, definitely, that AEW belt, which I'm still going to keep saying, one of the best looking belts in wrestling right now, that AEW Men's Championship belt, World Heavyweight Championship belt, looks beautiful. They are making that belt seem like the best belt to ever hold for wrestling, and I love it. With this match alone, this solidifies how much they care about those titles. These guys killed it. Go watch this match if you haven't seen it already. I give this match a cool. I give this a 9.5 out of 10. The only reason why I don't give it 10 out of 10 because I did want to see a actual winner and a loser here. It comes off as a draw. And I'm okay with that because I get it. They're trying to save up for the next time. I can only imagine what their next match is going to be. But this is a 9 out of 10 match. 9.5 out of 10 for me. So comment down below. Let me know. Did you watch this match? And what did you rate it? Is this one of your best matches this year? Is this one of your favorite matches of all time? Let me know. No answer is wrong. Put it down in the comment section down below. And please, for the love of God, none of this WWE, AEW stuff. Like, none of this. No, we're talking about just strictly this match. If you watched it, what did you think of it? Give it your rating on a scale of 1 to 10. And if you haven't watched it, I go advise it. If you want some good storytelling, good wrestling, good psychology, go watch it. I think you will enjoy. But I appreciate all the love and support. Road to 70K. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. See y'all on the next one. Peace.